11 News reporter Lowell Melser was at tonight's city council meeting. He joins us live with more. Lowell.
And you got to hand it to the Baltimore City Council. They certainly had a full plate tonight, passing several important tax hikes and moving through the controversial police and fire pension bill to a final reader. Now, representatives with the City Council President's office told us they were expecting to pass through about $23 million worth of bills tonight, but only got about $9 million. So with about 7 days to go, there is still plenty of work to be done.
The picketers took their usual spots in front of City Hall Monday, this particular crew from Ask Me, in support of the bottle tax, which remains a tabled issue but could reappear in the 11th hour. Inside, the city council was busy working on a number of bills to chip away at the city's $121 million budget. As far as bills now headed for final reader, the increase in hotel, energy, and supplemental taxes all went through, as did an increase in parking fines. An outdoor advertising bill was held until next meeting, as a leading advertiser in the city was trying to work out a deal with the council. Also making it through to final reader, the police and fire pension bill, angering the unions.
I'm surprised that police and fire still want to come to work, and I'm surprised that police and fire, who aren't here yet, want to come to Baltimore City. I'd encourage them not to come here. Don't come to work for Baltimore, because you have a mayor who lies, and you have a mayor who doesn't care about public safety, period.
Several city council members voted against the bill. Taxation and Finance Committee Chair Helen Holton defended the mayor's office and her committee, saying that they did all they could to come up with an agreement with the police and fire unions.
The legislation we're considering takes into consideration their recommendations, their suggestions, maybe not to the extent that they would have liked them to, but their comments, their concerns did not fall on deaf ears.
There were also a number of bills that were approved and are awaiting for the mayor's signature. Those include an increase in local income tax, shortening the time allotted for early payment of property taxes, and extending registration requirements for vacant structures in the city. Several amendments concerning both the parking and telecommunications tax increases were introduced, causing them to be held over as well, but both are expected to be approved at the next meeting.
And that meeting will happen later this week on Thursday night, where more bills are expected to be passed. It's unknown at this point whether the controversial bottle tax will reappear then or in the future on the last meeting on June 21st. Overall, though, the city council has until June 25th to finalize a budget. We're live at City Hall tonight. I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL-TV 11 News.